I recently took an active shooter training class. At first, I just thought it was going to be kind of a waste of time, but now that I took it, I'm really glad that I did because I learned a lot of stuff that I really didn't know. And previously, people were taught to just, and I think they still are taught this in schools, is you go into a room and you just sit down against the wall, basically making yourself a sitting duck and an easy target. That is not the way to survive an active shooter. The first way would be to run and escape if you can, out a window, out a door, any way you can to get away from that situation. Or second would be hide. So if you're going to hide, say in another room or something, make sure you use the minutes that you have to barricade that door as best as you can. Try to do everything you can to make sure that door can't open. And don't stand behind the door. And the last thing that you can do, and that would be the most horrific thing, would be if you had to confront the shooter in the same room. So you'd have to fight. There's nothing else you can do. The only alternative is that you're probably going to get shot. So you might as well give it all you got. So one way you can do that is to use a basic natural instinct that every animal, including humans, have, and that is this thing called the Odin loop, which is basically you use your senses to continuously monitor your surroundings and then orient yourself and decide what to do. So genetically, humans are programmed that if something is coming at you fast, like an object toward your face or your body, you're going to put your hands up. You're going to basically focus on that thing and stop it from hitting you because that could mean you are going to get hurt or killed. So this is the instinct, the genetically programmed instinct that you want to use to disorient the shooter so that then you can rush that guy and tackle him or do whatever you have to do to turn the situation around. So it's a terrible thing to think that you would have to do this, but this is your only choice, so you better try to use it to your advantage. And knowing about it is a very good thing because if you didn't get this training, you probably wouldn't you wouldn't have thought of this. So coming up is a video that demonstrates this OODA loop in action. So here we go.
So, we have a little practical exercise. I'll need a volunteer in a minute here. Sir, Counter, we're going to talk about the OODA loop, right? So, every creature on planet Earth, this is even science. This is a great class, right? So, every creature on planet Earth does this. No matter what you're doing, no matter how you're doing it, this is what you do. You can't even change it. When you want to do an action, you observe something, then you orientate yourself to it, then you decide, am I going to get it or not, and then you're going to act. And what's great about the OODA loop is, remember we talked about throwing cans and throwing bottles at an active shooter? Well, he's using this OODA loop to get you in the targets to shoot you, right? And what's great about this is it resets. You know, it's not like you stop the act and it goes to the side. No, it resets the beginning. So you're doing this every millisecond of your life, man. You're doing this all the time. I want to go eat lunch, I want to pick up my soda, I'm not going to put a straw in my soda. You're doing this like super quick. So if you interrupt the OODA loop, it resets, 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 resets. And at that time, when you're throwing stuff at the active shooter, you can tackle them down, get them, secure the weapon. You can do that. Everyone in this room can do that. Because if not, what's the alternative? Right? So it's important that you guys counter, and it works. I'll give you a little demonstration, sir, if you have a... Anyone, oh, wait, see, any volunteers? Oh, come on. Just going to get balls thrown at you, and they're really soft. And you guys, who gets to throw a balls at a kernel? Come on. See, we're soft. Right, really soft. So,
very soft.
So, they're going to throw them at you, sir.
All right.
All right. So, who has a ball? I can throw one. Here, sir. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to block his audio loop. We're going to mess with it. I'm going to ask him to focus on a something. And here you go, Ken. And we're going to focus. Here, Cheryl. You can throw one. See the core. And one more. Come on, more. Come on, one. 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 Oh, sorry. Hey, I'm a cop, not a baseball player. Hey. All right. So, sir, what I want you to do is what they're going to do is they're going to disrupt your audio loop.
All right.
And what I need you to do is focus on something. You can focus on the mic or the projector in the back and try and keep that focus. And they're going to see you already got alert because you know the balls are coming at you. Active shooter wouldn't know that. So go ahead. If you could focus on the item or individual. Wait, throw. Let's go. Throw. So what happens is this is a thank you, sir. Appreciate it. Yeah, thank you, Colonel. Yes, sir. I got one of the G357 lanyards from OPMG, Office of the Provost Marshal General. I don't want to see on eBay or anything, you know. So, well, sir. So what we did you see how he instantly went up? Right, he was trying to focus, but his hands went up. He tried to, you know, block the balls coming out. And he was just spongy, and he knew. Right, yeah, heads up, right? That the balls were coming. He knew that they were soft. He felt them. Could you imagine, like, an active shooter who isn't trained comes in the room with a gun? And you start throwing all kinds of crap at them, they're going to be ducking. That's natural, guys. Like when you ride your bicycle, beep, beep, right, ding, 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 you're on a bike, you fall off the bike. What does your hands automatically do? They cover your face. That's instinct. That's like primordial, man. That's just the way we're designed. That's where our DNA works. That's the way our brains work. That's why we're hotwired. So when things are coming at our head, we are genetically trained by our genes to protect ourselves. And the active shooters will do that. You're throwing stuff at them. They're going to protect them. When they're up there, like when he's up there protecting themselves, there's a couple of you in the room. Then you jump on them. Take the gun. Knock them down. Tie them up. If you don't, what's the alternative? Your picture on my damn active shooter briefing in 10 years. I don't want that. I don't want that. I want you to get home and see your friends and family. I want you to survive.
So here's another example of the OODA loop in action. The shooter is the guy in black there with the gun, and he's barging into the room looking for victims, and so these other people are ready for him, and the people on the right are going to hurl those objects at him to disorient him, and by instinct he will be disoriented and he will try to counteract those objects, and the guy with the fire extinguisher, I believe, is probably going to try to knock him out. Now, if you can knock the guy out or get him to the ground, subdue him, take his weapon away, and tie him up and wait for the authorities to get there. What you don't want to do is have his weapon in your hand. You want to put that weapon in a desk drawer, put it underneath a garbage can, whatever. Just don't have the weapon in your hand or visible, because the police have no idea what's going on in the building. They don't. It's basically chaos for them. And if they come in and see you waving a gun around, you very likely could get shot by the police. So you want to get rid of that gun till everything is sorted out with the police. So I hope this video has helped you to think about an active shooter situation and, you know, at least learned a few things about how to survive one of these.